the living entity wandering in different species of life, in different planetary platform. This is very disgusting. So if one is fortunate, then he comes in contact with the devotee. This Krishna consciousness movement is meant for giving this opportunity to everyone. We are opening centers all over the world, inviting people to come in our place, understand the philosophy. We have got so many books, and try to save yourself from this botheration of repetition of birth and death. In order to execute this business, apparently there is little difficulty. Just like we prescribe to our members, no intoxication. No intoxication, one who is habituated to drink, to smoke, to drink coffee, tea, etc., he feels some discomfort. Similarly, we say no meat eating. So those who are meat eaters, they will find little difficulty to give up this habit. Similarly, we say no illicit sex. But one who is habituated for this illicit sex life, he feels some difficulty. So there are so many things. In the beginning, it appears to be little difficult. Actually, it is not difficult, but because we are habituated, we feel difficult. So, if you are actually anxious and serious to stop this repetition of birth and death, then we must take to Krishna consciousness. Because without Krishna consciousness, nobody can stop the repetition of birth and death. Therefore, Krishna advises in this verse that accept this little difficulty. Actually, there is no difficulty, but because you have practiced, in the beginning we find little difficulty. Therefore, here Krishna says, janghina bhathayanti ete, all these so-called difficulties, if they do not bother, give some pain to a person. Just like I am feeling difficult. I am habituated to smoke, now I am forbidden not to smoke. So I am feeling difficulty. So therefore Krishna says, so although it is not difficulty, but although one feels difficulty, still he sticks to the principle, then he becomes fit for going back to home.
Thank you very much.